Hello everyone! In this video, you will learn about the coastal plains. What is a coastal plain? A coastal plain is flat, low-lying land adjacent to a sea coast. The coastal plains of India lie on either side of the peninsular plateau, along the western and eastern coasts of India. To understand it better, let us have a look at the map of India. Here, you can see the peninsular plateau of India. And these are the western and the eastern edges of plateaus, known as the western ghats and the eastern ghats respectively. West of western ghats, we have the western coastal plain. Whereas, east of eastern ghats, we have the eastern coastal plain. These coastal plains are narrow stretch of land running along the Arabian Sea on the west and the Bay of Bengal on the east. Do you want to know more about these coastal plains? Then must watch the full video. The western coastal plain is sandwiched between the western ghats and the Arabian Sea. It consists of three sections, 1, 2 and 3. The northern part of the coast is called the Konkan Plain, which runs from Mumbai to Goa. The central stretch is called the Kannad Plain. It is in Karnataka, while the southern stretch is referred to as the Malabar coast. It is in Kerala. Now, let us learn about the eastern coast in detail. It is sandwiched between the eastern ghat and the Bay of Bengal. It has two sections, 1 and 2. In the northern part, it is referred to as the Northern Sirkar, while the southern part is known as the Coromandel Coast. Here in the eastern coast, you will find the largest saltwater lake in the country. Any idea about which lake I am talking? Yes, you are right. It is Chilka Lake. It lies in the state of Odisha, to the south of the Mahanadi Delta. Somewhere here. And it is separated from the mighty Bay of Bengal by a small strip of sand. Do you know, the western coastal plain is a narrow plain land, whereas the eastern coastal plain is wide and level. But why? It is because of the rivers, such as the Mahanadi, the Godavari, the Krishna and the Kaveri. All these rivers deposit sediments at the river's mouth due to the gentle slope of the land. As a result, extensive delta is formed on this coast, which makes it wider. Hope this is clear to you. So children, let us end today's class here. In the next video, we will learn about the Indian islands. Do like and subscribe to my channel if you found my video interesting. Thank you, everyone.